notice in one year charts, right? You can have up your data table on your Chromebooks from your SIN yesterday.
My name is Hallie Edgerly. I teach 8th grade science at ADM Middle School in Adel. Today's lesson is following the students using a simulator yesterday. So prior to this lesson, we had done a lot of hands-on things where they learned about the different relationships between pressure, how they affect other variables, and how high pressure and low pressure have a relationship out in the natural world. So today they're looking at data they collected from a simulator. We're gonna do some analysis of it, what they notice about the data, what they're wondering about the data, and how it helps explain how a rain cloud would be formed and what's the potential that that rain or that that cloud will rain.
This lesson is like really cool because I enjoy the weather. I like learning about it, and it also helps to like learn about it like and like see outside and just to like see like a true visual of it, and like it's cool to see how the sim works and everything.
Whenever there's an event or maybe something close by in your community, that always helps to explain something that's going on in class. So for example, today and yesterday when we were talking about wind happening, we got to share that regionally tomorrow we're expecting some super high winds of like 70 mile per hour gusts is what they're forecasting. And we're talking about why wind happens, and the students are able to relate to that when they go outside and experience the really high winds that are happening and what that does to surrounding, you know, locations, or figuring out on a weather map why that's happening and be able to see it in real time. When we're doing noticing and wonderings about the content that they're learning about, some students are already checked out, to be completely honest, because they don't really care about whatever it is you're learning about. It feels very abstract to them. It feels very unconnected to them. So being able to bring in like, did you notice that the weatherman said this? Or if you were reading on the weather app today about whatever is gonna be happening, or did anybody else's weather radio go off in their house this morning because there's gonna be a high wind warning? You know, finding ways to make it relatable to them, which is where phenomena can play a part.
What are you noticing here in our picture?
I think the best part was when she was like explaining it, she connected it to things we'd already learned. And so I thought it was easy to understand it, and it was easy to put it all together and understand the whole learning target. I've always wondered like why the wind is there before this, and now I know like the wind, like, cause you always think, why is the wind there? What's its purpose? And now I know that it makes clouds.